bisecting came in, and the performance of bisecting came in is much better than the came in clustering. Okay, how it works? We already learned the came in clustering. Okay, so output of the came in clustering is a K cluster. Okay, so bisecting came in means it will form two clusters. But if we want to find, if we have the information that there are six clusters, so how do we proceed? So you see the algorithm here. So initialize the list of the clusters L. So first you consider the entire data set is a single cluster. So that is first, it is, this is one cluster, and you consider this is C1, and then you put in a list. So that list initially consists of a single cluster. Now remove a cluster from the list of clusters. So there is only one cluster. You remove the cluster, so then this will be null. So there will be no cluster here. First situation. Now what you do is you do it, bisect the selected cluster using k-mean clustering method for a number of times. So first you consider the entire data set is a cluster. So first you have a list. So entire data set C. And then C1 is equal to the data set. Next, you remove from here. So this will be null. Okay. So this will be null. And now entire data set, you got the entire data set, and you apply the k-mean clustering. And what is the value of k? K equal to 2. So then you will get a cluster, let's say C11 and C12. And you apply a number of times. Let's say 10 times or 12 times or 15 times you apply the k-mean. So on the same cluster, that is same data. Here in this first example, C1 cluster. So then you will get the result C, let's say 21, C22. Another time you apply C31 and C32. Each time you will get the two clusters. Then you will apply C41, C42 and so on. And for each clustering, this is something called clustering in together. For each clustering, you compute the SSE, sum of the square error. We know how to compute the sum of the square error. For each case, we compute the SSE. Let's say this is SSE 1, this is 2, SSE, this is 3, SSE, this is 4, and so on. And you choose a clustering. Not cluster, you choose a clustering, however SSE value is minimum among the clustering. So select two clusters, that means each clustering gives two clusters. Select two clusters from a bisection with lowest total SSE. So we apply the k-mean with k equal to 2 many times. And each clustering means apply the k-mean one time and you find the two cluster and compute the SSE. Again, from with two different initial point, you compute, you apply the k-mean, you will get the two clusters and you compute the SSE. And among these all clustering, each clustering will give the two clusters and one SSE value. Wherever the SSE value is minimum, you consider that clustering. So that two cluster you add to the list here. What is the list? Length is null because you have taken out, you have removed one cluster. Now there is no cluster here. So now your list will have two clusters, let's say sum C1 and C2. Add these two clusters to the list of the cluster L until the number of cluster in the list L is k. Say suppose k value you have taken k equal to 5. So number of cluster is 2. Then again you have to repeat this step. What is this step? Remove a cluster from the list of clusters. So from C1, C2, again you take out one cluster. So let's say you take out C1 and again you partition it using bisecting k-mean many times and you choose the minimum SSE. So you will get two clusters. You have to choose a clustering consist of two clusters because every time you are using the same k-mean, where SSE value is minimum. So you'll get two cluster, you add these two cluster into the list. Earlier you had one cluster, now you add another two cluster here. So number of cluster will be one more. So it will be three. So in each every iteration you will add it one by one cluster. So then your list is C1, C2, and then C3. But is five, you need five. Again, you take out one of the, you remove one of the cluster and apply the bisecting came in for many times. And you choose a clustering because bisecting came in, each clustering will have two clusters. And you choose a clustering wherever the SAC value is minimum. And then you add it here. Earlier it was three. You remove one, so it becomes two, and you add two, so it becomes four now. Again, you take out one, apply the same k-mean many number of times, and you choose a clustering, and you add again two, so it become four. You take out one, so now it's three, three plus two, five. So you reach the number of cluster five. So that is the final output. Obviously, complexity will be much better than the. More complexity will be not better. Complexity will be more than the traditional k-mean. So what happened? What you can see eventually? So you had one big cluster, that is the dataset D. Then from you got the two clusters, and then you added to the list. So you had two cluster. Now this cluster you remove, and then next level you got again. Same cluster here, so you got three clusters. Any one of them, again you divided it. This is one, this is one. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4. Again you divide any one of them. So maybe here, and then you will get total five clusters. So you will get a hierarchical clustering. But finally, you will concentrate here. So this is the final results here. So while talking about the k-mean clustering, we said the SAC value. So that is the SSE. We have to optimize the SSE value. What is the objective? To get the minimum SSE value for it, k number of clusters. And then how we said, we compute the SSE value is something for each cluster, and then sum this value, and then we got this one. Okay. So this can be seen as an optimization problem. And for the simplicity, what we consider? We'll compute the squared Euclidean distance. What is like squared Euclidean distance? What is Euclidean distance? Is like si minus yi square summation over this one, right? So what do you do it? We consider this one is the measures, and for simplicity, what we consider? So this is the distance. So distance is defined at. This is summation over all dimension I equal to 1 to d psi yi square. And not only that, we consider I equal to d equal to 1. So it is a single dimensional data. So easily it can be extended to multi-dimensional. Okay. So in that case, what will be that formulation? So formulation will be minimize the SSE value. Minimize SSE value for all cluster i equal to 1 to k, k capital here. Okay, I equal to 1 to k, so you have k cluster, let's say. And summation over each data point, summation over each cluster, for each cluster, what you have to do, you have to compute a point, and you have to compute the distances. Now you have to identify what is that point. We know this is a centroid earlier. So, but now we will see formally, you consider a point from where the all other distances will be minimum. So you consider that point. Then we finally prove that point is nothing but the centroid. So this is, you have to minimize. That means for minimization, what you have to do is, so we have to find the point within a center. So we need to differentiate with di by d, let's say ck. We have considering only one cluster ck, so this k is smaller. Okay, and then what you have to do, you have to compute SSE, and this should be zero. So then one, we can write it del c k is smaller here. Okay, summation over i equal to 1 to, sorry, I equal to 1 to capital K summation over x c, let's say c cluster ci into this is the point c small ci minus x square. Okay, so this is okay, let me write, this is we want to find the point c and this is the point ci within a cluster c and this is a cluster ci, this is a capital C. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to consider this value is zero and we are considering with the kth cluster because we have the k cluster and let's say first we are computing with respect to the within a cluster where should be the point that minimum distance will be minimum and that will contribute to the total SSE value. Okay, so therefore what you can do it from here, so summation over I equal to 1 to capital K, that is the K number of cluster we are considering, then summation X that is cluster Ci del del Ck into this is actually we are considering cluster key Ck, so then this is Ck minus X square and this is no longer I, so this is a Ck cluster, kth cluster and that should be zero. And for all other cases we are not considering, so this sum you can cancel out. Okay, so then what we got it, summation over del del smaller Ck because this is a point, with this point we are differentiating, into Ck this is also smaller minus X square is equal to zero. Now if you differentiate here, so here what will you get it, here Ck minus X square and if differentiating with Ck, so therefore 2 into summation over 2 into Ck minus X. Okay, equal to 0. Okay, from here we can write it, what we can write it, summation over Ck minus, this is smaller Cm, Ck minus summation over X, summation over the points, summation over the point X, C cap, this is a cluster, kth cluster X minus Ck. Okay, this should be 0. So from here what you can write it, summation over X Ck, Ck equal to summation over X where X belongs to cluster Ck. So from here this is summation over the point X but here inside there is no point X. Okay, so then you can write N into Ck is the point, that is N into Ck equal to summation over X, X is C capital X. Okay, so then here you can write Ck, that is the point we are searching, equal to 1 by N into summation X, where X is okay, so Ck is nothing but the centroid, that is the all points summation divided by the number of points. So here this point is nothing but the centroid. So we are trying to find a point wherever the SSE value is minimum and it found that point is nothing but the centroid of the each cluster. So similarly here if you consider the SSE value is nothing but elon distance. So if you consider the distance, earlier you considered this distance is summation over xi yi square where I equal to 1 to d. Now if you consider the distance is nothing but the L1 distance. L1 distance is nothing but this one. So therefore, SSE value will be summation over I to k. So k is the total number of clusters, and the x belongs to class ci, and ci minus xj. So you have to find what is ci. For simplicity, what you can consider, this is a one-dimensional case. Same way, what you do it, del del ck, smaller ck of SAC, SAC sum of the error. So this will be sum of the absolute error. So this is sum of the okay. This should be zero. Okay. So therefore, same way you can write delta del C, delta del CK, summation over x belongs to CK cluster. You can write CK minus x. This should be zero. So what will be the derivative of this part? So we define mod x equal to x if x is greater than 0, mod x equal to minus x if x less than 0. So therefore, if you ck minus x is greater than 0, then we can write ck minus x. And if you take derivative of del del ck of ck minus x, so this will be 1. Now if you take this value, that means x minus ck, x is greater than in this case minus x. So if you put minus x here, so minus minus plus, so x minus ck. So if you take the derivative of del del ck, you will get minus 1. So now if you take the summation of plus 1 minus 1, you will get 0. So plus 1, some cases minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, you will get the value 0, because summation of these all derivative values will be 0. When this will appear, so that is number of plus 1 and number of minus 1 is same. So that means actually if you have a clusters here and you have a set of points here, you choose a point on the left side, there will be on left side and right side there will be equal number of points if you assign the point in that way. So in the other way around, so this is nothing but the median of the all data points. Let's say example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So this is median is here. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Median is somewhere here. Okay. So now you do it. This is CK. And these all are X. These all are X. Now you CK minus 1. So 5 minus 1. So this will be plus 4. However, CK minus 9, so 5 minus 9 it will be minus 4. Similarly, this will be plus 3, this will be minus 3, and so on. So ultimately, what you will get, this is the original values. Ultimately, this represents that this is nothing but the median of the distribution. So median of the distribution is nothing but the, if you take the multidimensional, so it is nothing but the centroid. So next we will talk about something. To speed up the k-mean clustering algorithm. So if we move back, k-mean clustering, if you see here, k-mean clustering. So what is,
I stop today's class here. Okay, next day I'll start from the, I had some other work from 5 o'clock. So I am stopping at this point. So hopefully you understood. If you have any doubt, maybe in the next class we can talk over it. Is it okay?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
I
Yes,
will
sir. Yes.
upload this video. I will upload this video by tonight, and you go through it. Okay. So I end this class today.